من أشباه الحقائق.
Otherwise, if this situation continues, we will never really quite spot or understand the reality of the situation.
وسيستمر الاستنزاف للشعب العراقي إلى أن يصل إلى مرحلة قد لا نستطيع إيجاد الحلول لها بعد ذلك.
If this situation continues and the Iraqi people are allowed to bleed in this way, we might not be able to control the situation in the near future.
ووجود حالة الانتهازية السياسية لدى بعض الفرقاء السياسيين في العراق من الذين يتعاونون بشكل أو بآخر مع المحتل أيضا ألحقت الضرر بالعملية السياسية والتي ترتب عليها الكثير من الضرر على الملف الأمني.
Another negative feature of the situation in Iraq is the existence of political opportunism and political opportunists who have complicated the political struggle within Iraq and created further complications and confusion.
كل هذه الأسباب ألقت بظلالها الثقيلة على أبناء الشعب.
All these factors put together have thrown a very harmful shadow and a very harmful situation of enforced on the Iraqi.
فصار حلم العوائل أن تنام بسلام لتستيقظ بسلام.
One of the fondest dreams of families in Iraq is to sleep in peace and wake up in peace.
ودعاء الأمهات أن يعودوا أبنائهم وأزواجهم إلى البيوت بأمان.
And the mothers appeals to the Almighty for their children to come back home safely.
هذا المشهد المأساوي لا أدعي هذا واقع حال لكل من ذهب إلى العراق واستقرأ بعينيه وشاهد حالة السوء الكبير في هذا البلد.
This tragic picture I paint to you is not something that I am inventing. It can be seen and witnessed by all people who visit Iraq.
لكن لا زال هنالك الكثير من المؤمنين والوطنيين يحاولون إعادة ترميم ما يمكن ترميمه من هذا البناء المهدوم.
But there are still a lot of believers and patriots who are working hard to remedy the situation and remedy the bad situation that Iraq is in.
ومن كل الفصائل والفرق والمذاهب في العراق بلا استثناء.
These people belong or come from all religions, sects, and ethnic groups in the country.
لقاءنا بكم هنا ما الذي يستطيع أن يضفيه على تلك الحالة وذلك المشهد الحزين؟
My meeting with you here today is to try to reflect on what goes on in Iraq and try to present to you a true picture of that situation inside the country.
هذا السؤال قد أجيب عنه أنا أولاً وأترك لكم ابتكار الوسائل الثانية.
I am posing this portrayal as a question to you to see how we can benefit from each other and acquire an understanding of what goes on in Iraq.
الإنسانية في العراق تنتهك.
Humanity in Iraq is being violated.
فلا بد منكم أن تستشعروا هذه الحالة وأن تمسحوا بلمسات اللطيفة على بلسم على جراح العراقيين عسى أن تكون بلسما لهم.
We hope that you will understand this and use your sympathy for the Iraqi people, because this sympathy and your understanding will come as a blessing or as a coolant for the wounds that the Iraqi people are suffering from.
ساعدونا في أن نرفع الأصوات تلو الأصوات لمطالبة قوات الاحتلال بالرحيل عن بلادنا.
Help us to get rid of the occupation forces in Iraq.
أعينونا على أن نوقف الحرب الطائفية التي ينفخ فيها قوات تكفيرية بدعم من قوات الاحتلال.
Help us stop a degeneration into civil war that is being stoked up by the Takfiri movements backed by the occupation.
وعلينا ألا نستهين بقدراتنا جميعا، فلرب سبب بسيط غير الشيء الكثير.
We should not underestimate our own strength, because sometimes even small forces can overturn or tip a situation.
الحقيقة أنا لا أعرف يعني الزاوية التي ترون فيها إلى العراق، لذلك سوف أتيح لكم المجال لتوجيه الأسئلة وأنا بخدمتكم.
I don't quite obviously understand where you're coming from in terms of your understanding of Iraq, but please ask any question you like and I'll try to answer your questions.
Thank you very much for your touching words there. I know that most people at SOAS would like to send their warm wishes to you, and hopefully we can do something together to bring the troops home. We'll talk about that a bit later. Okay, so we're going to take questions now. I'm not quite sure how I'm going to do it, but look, I'll see what the questions are, and perhaps we can take a bunch together and then answer them at the same time. Yeah. So, okay, gentlemen here at the front first.
At the weekend on Sunday, there was a picture of our Minister of Defence looking down a telescopic sight of a sniper rifle. Is there some way of instilling in Mr. Blair and Mr. Reid that war is obscene, it's medieval, it shouldn't just give you a license to kill children and adults? You should come in afterwards with medical equipment, with engineers. You should know that you've created the most terrible situation. There should be an equation that if you go to war, you kill, but you've also got an obligation to take artificial limbs to children, medical supplies. Last night we saw a little baby dying because the needle was not small enough for the baby. Can we do something about this obscenity?
In the front, in the middle there, and then I'll come to you next.
There's much talk nowadays about possible civil war in Iraq. Ayad Allawi has actually said there's a civil war now. I believe there won't be a sectarian civil war in Iraq because there's a tribal society. I also think the Americans, the occupation forces, are not helping, they're making things worse, and therefore they should leave. However, I do think that there can be a civil war along power lines, as in any other country. So I'd like to see what's your take on that, and especially if there's no peacekeeping force, for example, UN, if possible.
Okay.
في الحقيقة أن ما تفضلت به صحيح، أن الشعب العراقي متداخل بشكل كبير جدا، لا فرق بين سني وشيعي ولا فرق بين عربي وكردي، والعوائل العراقية متكونة من هذا الخليط ومن هذا النسيج، ولا يوجد تمييز. وهذا الكلام ليس للاستهلاك الإعلامي، بل هذا واقع الحال في أسرنا التي نعتاش في وسطها.
He shares your point regarding what sort of war that might erupt in Iraq. A war between communities is extremely unlikely because most Iraqis have mixed ethnicities, mixed religions, mixed sects, and this degree intermarriage and mixing is highly developed in the country, so it's unlikely that these communities will fight such a communal type war.
ولكن النفخ الطائفي هو وافد على العراقيين من الخارج. نحن لا ننسى العلاقة التي تجمع بعض الجهات الإرهابية مع